Hi, I'm Christian. Hello and welcome to episode number 9 of ControlX Developer. Most of you know it already. In here, it's all about our new ControlX automation platform. Episode 9, of course, means there have been 8 previous exciting episodes. You can find them in the playlist or in the description below. Today, it's not really about us. It's about you, our community. And for this, I have today Pedro with me, Director of Business Digital at Bosch Rexroth, and therefore responsible for the ControlX automation community. Hello, Pedro.
Hi, Christian. Thanks for inviting me.
I'm glad to have you here because I think you can share some really good insights from a totally different perspective. Why don't you introduce yourself and explain your role in ControlX automation?
Sure. I'm Pedro, and I'm responsible for Business Digital at Bosch Rexroth. This is everything about inform, configure, and also support of our products in a digital manner. And today, Christian, we are going to talk about the support. Our ControlX automation community helps the customers in every step with our product. I worked for almost 15 years at Bosch Rexroth in R&D as a developer responsible for some teams. And Christian, since you are the interface between our developers and the customers, I'm your service provider.
That's right. And I think my team is going to be the power user of our community. We are already all into it, into the forums, the how-tos, and so on. But tell us more about the community.
Sure, Christian, that's why I'm here. The ControlX automation community is more than a forum. It's a control center that helps the developers to implement any kind of project with ControlX automation.
Wow, this definitely sounds ambitious. How do we achieve this?
Look, I'll show you.
Yes, please.
Well, the community consists of 5 areas of interest. Everything starts with the app zone, where you can find own and third-party apps. I think, Christian, you already talked about this in last episodes.
Yes, we've introduced them already.
And then we've got the how-to area, where you can get FAQs and step-by-step instructions to start implementing your application with ControlX automation. The next area is the forum, where you can get help and support from the community, including our experts. And then we've got the online documentation, where you can get all detailed information about our products.
And then there's a connection to GitHub, which I think is really cool and totally new to us.
Exactly, Christian. And then there's GitHub with its common known features. So, Christian, where should we start now?
It all sounds exciting. My very first question would be, how do I get to the community?
Well, Christian, it's very easy. First of all, everybody can access the community at any time without even a login. So simply go to controlx-automation.com/community.
And if I want to ask a question in the forum?
That's also very easy. You can just log in with your Bosch ID.
Okay, and for those who do not have a Bosch ID?
This is for sure also very easy. You can simply register and get a Bosch ID using your email address, and afterwards you will be part of the community.
Talking about active members, I think I have a very specific question which I think the community could help to answer.
Perfect, Christian. That's a very good idea. So let's use the forum for ask your question.
Yeah. My question would be, can I program an app with a SDK using Python language? And if yes, why do we provide a separate Python app?
So this is very easy. Basically, we just go to the forum. Let's open it. And here, Christian, you will find all the categories that we have related to the product families that we have. Basically, Python programming is part of the ControlX Works,
correct.
So software and engineering toolbox. So let's dive in. And Christian, since this is a new topic, we imagine we have already searched about it. Let's start a new topic. So here I can write my subject. So Python programming and ControlX Core Python runtime app. I already prepared something. So here we go. Just posted. And Christian, you know what? I expect a reply in several minutes.
Let's see what happens. I've seen there's also some discussion between our internal colleagues, and you write a lot too.
Of course, Christian. So we thought, why not use the community also for internal issues and discussions that also customers can read?
Yes, of course. This would be also interesting for our customers to see what we are working on.
Exactly, and very important to us, we don't have a special community management team or something. So with us, every expert is part of the community, and that's very important.
So it's a real community, not just a service.
Exactly. There are real experts as part of the community, contributing to the community and bringing the answers to the question of our customers and, of course, of any kind of developers we have.
Okay. I've seen the developers have contributed a lot of content already. How many questions do we have in the forum yet?
Well, actually, I cannot really tell you, but it should be around 800 questions that we have answered already.
Okay. The platform is also open to customers, mm-hmm. and I think we have already customers in the community today, right?
Right, we have. And very important for us, the customers can also request new features and give feedback to our product. And this is really new to us and this is a real value to us. So we want to get all this information directly also for product enhancements and for further product developments.
This means every customer requirement will directly influence our product development. So if you have any question or idea out there regarding Controlix automation,
or automation in general.
Or automation in general. Just post it in the forum and we will discuss it. Then let's take a look what we have developed together already.
So you're talking about the AppZone?
Yes.
So let's have a close look. The AppZone contains Bosch Rexroth, Controlix automation apps, as well as Controlix World partner apps, all in one place. So Christian, let me just show it to you, okay?
Yes.
As you can see, you can find Bosch Rexroth as well as partner apps. Here, for instance, you see the Wittenstein Synapse Monitor app. Above, you can filter between runtime, engineering, services, and SDK. So runtime are the apps that are directly running on the target. Engineering is the complete world of software development that we offer to our customers. Services are the digital services and cloud services that we provide with our products. And the filter of SDK is used for everything about software development.
Can you show us one app?
For sure. Let's choose an app. So here we have the VPN client app. And as you can see, you get all information about the VPN client app in one place. You see the most important information and you get directly related links. For instance, the documentation and the link to the forum. And in future, you will be able to directly buy the app or download the app directly all in one place.
Then the whole thing is like an app library.
That's right. With your Controlix Core web UI or using the Controlix device portal, you are very easy able to manage and install your apps.
So it's as easy as on a smartphone, like we've talked about in episode 2. By the way, we have linked the corresponding episode in the description below.
Very good. Do you have any other questions about the AppZone?
No, but if I do, I just post them in the forum. Seriously, I'm very curious about the other components of the community.
Well, for example, let's look on the how-to area. There we will find everything for getting started programming on the Controlix Core and Controlix Automation. You will find step-by-step instructions and the most important questions are already answered.
For example, the question, how do I use a router to connect my control to the internet?
Correct, and all the settings you need.
Or in case you ask yourself how to use the REST API, because Johannes explained it a little bit too fast last week in episode 8.
That's right. So in the how-to area, everything is explained step by step. So Christian, let me show you. Let's go to the how-to area. There we will find a how-to use REST API of Controlix Core. And I'll just open that. And here you have a step-by-step instruction on how to use REST API in your REST-based application, including videos, step-by-step instructions, screenshots, and on the bottom line, you have related links. So it means if you have a question, you can place it in the forum, or if you want to read the documentation, there you will find a lot of details.
Okay. Talking about essential information, the documentation is also linked in the community.
That's right. And I'll show it to you. So, as you have already correctly stated, we also integrated the classical product documentation. You will find the online documentation as part of the community, and also the idea behind it is that we want to improve the documentation also based on the community and based on customer feedbacks.
For you developers out there, this is your opportunity to make Controlix automation even better through your input.
Right, and for those who want to use open source directly from the Controlix team, we provide a GitHub channel. Let's look onto GitHub. Here we have two repositories. The first one is the JSON schema, and the other one is Node-RED. We have a Node-RED library for Controlix Core.
And Node-RED is the IoT environment.
Exactly. The Node-RED libraries are available first as open source directly within GitHub, and second within the Node-RED environment. So you can directly install it within Node-RED.
And of course, we make use of all the GitHub functionalities.
That's right. So we use GitHub for open source, and furthermore, we use Git for our own code, plus the customers can use Git for managing source code directly within the Controlix core. But Christian, what should I tell you? I think you know that better than me.
I think you explained it quite well.
Thank you, Christian. So summarized, you can use Git and you can use open source on GitHub, and you can be sure there will be more and more in the future. So we have another point open. Let's look to our forum, right?
Yes, let's see if something has changed.
All right. So let's go back to the overview. Oh, and what I can see, there are already two replies. Let's open it. So here we go. That's my question. And for sure, I'm just asking for a friend. Johannes just replied, "Hi Pedro, the support of Python in the SDK is still in preparation. And the target date is about March 2021. Regards, Johannes." And Jochen also replied, "Hi, already today it's possible to interpret and run Python scripts using the Python app on the Controlix core." Hmm, that's good. And the scripts can be easily deployed as part of the configuration.
So the forum is really helpful if you have questions about the Controlix automation platform. Thank you, Pedro, for explaining the community so thoroughly.
You're welcome, Christian. And if you want to become part of the Controlix automation community, no matter if you are a Controlix user or not, we are looking forward to you.
There's nothing to add to this except that it was a pleasure for me. See you on the next episode on December 17th, which is all about programming with Python. If you still have questions, don't hesitate to comment them below. And don't forget to click on the subscribe button so you won't miss any of the further episodes. Until then, catch you on the next one to be two steps ahead.